Excuse me. Excuse me. Hi. I'm sorry to startle you. I just well, you work in this office building, right? Yeah, I thought so. I see you every morning, so not in a stalker way, just again about my business way, and you just happen to be there. And anyway, I was just wondering if you wouldn't mind terribly just giving my resume to whoever's in charge. I'm really, really sorry for asking this. It's just, I don't even know how to say it without sounding pathetic, but I'm in a real bind, and I need a job really badly. Okay, I guess in order to get you to hand in the resume, I kind of have to sell myself, or you to sell me to whoever. Okay, here goes. I am a really hard worker. I'll do whatever you ask me to do. I'll show up on time. I will stay late. I get along really well with people. I'm not too bossy. I'm not too meek. I just really want a job. And everybody that comes out of this office seems so happy and contented, and like going to work isn't even a job, so. If I've inconvenienced you in any way, I'm really sorry. I just, something in me just had to ask. I'll just go. I'm sorry for wasting your time. What? Oh. Are you serious? No. Oh, I can't even. That's. Thank you. Thank you so much. Maybe I could give you my email address or my number, and I can find some way to thank you. Maybe some money or a gift or. Really? No, I can't have you do it for free. I have to give you something. I mean, I know I'm not exactly in the best circumstances, but I have to say thank you somehow. Are you really, really, really sure? I mean, I shouldn't have even asked you. I always see you, you know, like when I walk my dog in the morning, and you always seem really nice. You know, like you hold the door open for people and you smile, and I always see you buying loads of coffee for the office, so. Okay. Well, here. No, I realize you can't make any promises. I mean, it's down to my resume, right? Thank you so much. Really. Thank you. Oh, yeah. My name's T.
Done.
Night, Helen. Nah, I'm gonna stay late again. That is because I have no life, Helen. Drive safe. Okay, come on, T. Stay awake. I didn't know you were staying late. You're in the same boat as me. You're just too much of a worrywart to come away. Well, I told you, I'm a hard worker. Says you. What are you working on? That does not sound like fun. just the reports. Nothing too difficult, just tedious. Well, it's not really a wonder that I learned so much so quickly, is it? You know, when the boss said, make sure she's comfortable, I don't think he meant do everything for her and tell her not to worry about it. You can't even deny it. Oh, come on, I wasn't that nervous when I started. I was not. Okay, maybe I stammered a bit and I was a bit pale in the face, but come on, who isn't when they first start work? Or when they first creepily walk up to somebody who's working in an office building and say, please give them my resume, please, please, please. I still can't believe I did that. I'm so sorry. Desperate times call for desperate measures, or something like that. Okay, no, I'm not really that sorry. I mean, it got me this job, right? And it got me such wonderful coworkers. And it got me free coffee. And it got me money. And it got me insurance. And it got me. It got me a really great friend. Here's me talking about you. I mean it, you know. What I said before. That thank you could never be enough. I mean, you listen to a crazy girl on the street who was a stuttering, stammering, nervous wreck. And you took her resume and you said, no worries. And not only did you get me a job, and not only did you make me feel comfortable and show me what to do and be a friend to me, you. I mean, you bring me lunch boxes. You're just. You're amazing. And I feel really embarrassed. Because. You constantly tell me that I'm a hard worker. I'm always staying late, I'm always going the extra mile, I'm always pushing myself to be the best. And while I want to do a good job, I want to part of the team and contribute. I also just really want to spend time with you. And I know it's probably even creepier than when I came up to you on the street. But I'm a really bad liar, and sooner or later you're gonna notice me looking at you, staring at you, and your annoying silence will be worse than anything. So I would rather just be the idiot that announces it outright, and then we can move on. I really, really like you. Not just as a coworker or an amazing friend. I really like you. And I'm not trying to push myself onto you or make you feel uncomfortable in any way. That's not what I'm trying to do. I'm just trying to tell you that whatever you want to do with that information, it's cool. I just wanted you to know. Okay, I'll finish this and I will get out of your hair. Sorry for springing that on you. I know it's not something that you wanted to... what just happened? You... What? You like me too? Really? I mean, like, really, really? Or just humoring me, really? Or pitying me, really? Or... I don't really understand. Okay, that didn't feel like pity. You really do like me? I always see you, you know, like when I walk my dog in the morning, and you always seem really nice. You know, like you hold the door open for people and you smile, and I always see you buying loads of coffee for the office, so. Okay. Well, here. I realize you can't make any promises. I mean, it's down to my resume, right? thank you so much. Really. Thank you. Oh, yeah. My name's T. I just really want a job. And everybody that comes out of this office seems so happy and contented, and like going to work isn't even a job, so. If I've inconvenienced you in any way, I'm really sorry. I just. Something in me just. Had to ask. I'll just go. I'm sorry for wasting your time. What? Oh. Are you serious? No. I can't even. Thank you so much. Maybe I could give you my email address or my number, and I can find some way to thank you. Maybe some money or a gift or. Really? No. I can't have you do it for free. I have to give you something. I mean, I know I'm not exactly in the best circumstances, but I have to say thank you somehow. Are you really, really, really sure? I mean, I shouldn't have even asked you. I just. Oh. Night, Helen. Nah, I'm gonna stay late again. That is because I have no life, Helen. Drive safe. Okay, come on, T. Stay awake. Hey, I didn't know you were staying late. You're in the same boat as me. You're just too much of a worrywart to come away. Well, I told you, I'm a hard worker. Says you. What are you working on? Oh, that does not sound like fun. just the reports. Nothing too difficult, just tedious. Well, it's not really a wonder that I learned so much so quickly, is it? You know, when the boss said, make sure she's comfortable, I don't think he meant do everything for her and tell her not to worry about it. You can't even deny it. Oh, come on, I wasn't that nervous when I started. I was not. Okay, maybe I stammered a bit and I was a bit pale in the face, but come on, who isn't when they first start work? Mm-hmm. Or when they first creepily walk up to somebody who's working in an office building and say, please give them my resume, please. Please, please. I still can't believe I did that. I'm so sorry. Desperate times call for desperate measures, or something like that. Okay. No, I'm not really that sorry. I mean, it got me this job, right? And it got me such wonderful coworkers. And it got me free coffee. And it got me money. And it got me insurance. And it got me. It got me a really great friend. Excuse me. Excuse me. Hi. I'm sorry to startle you. I just well, you work in this office building, right? Yeah, I thought so. I see you every morning, so not in a stalker way, just getting about my business way, and you just happen to be there. And anyway, I was just wondering if you wouldn't mind terribly just giving my resume to whoever's in charge. I'm really, really sorry for asking this. It's just, I don't even know how to say it without sounding pathetic, but I'm in a real bind, and I need a job really badly. Okay, I guess in order to get you to hand in the resume, I kind of have to sell myself, or you to sell me to whoever. Okay, here goes. I am a really hard worker. I'll do whatever you ask me to do. I'll show up on time. I will stay late. I get along really well with people. I'm not too bossy. I'm not too mean.